वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टॉपिक दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ मटेरियल्स इन प्लांट्स. नाउ प्लांट्स नीड्स शुगर एंड वाटर टू स्टे अलाइव एज वेल एज दे नीड वेरियस न्यूट्रिएंट्स. सो दीज न्यूट्रिएंट्स आर ऑब्टेन्ड बाय प्लांट्स फ्रॉम द सॉइल थ्रू सनलाइट एंड ऑल. सो दैट मटेरियल हैज टू बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड फ्रॉम वन पार्ट टू अनदर पार्ट. सो वाटर नीड्स टू ट्रैवल फ्रॉम द रूट्स टू द लीव्स एंड अगेन शुगर नीड्स टू ट्रैवल फ्रॉम द लीव्स टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द प्लांट्स. So xylem is the tissue which are like the hollow dead tubes, and mainly they are responsible for the transportation of water and minerals. They are made up of lignin and very strong, so that they also help the in providing the support to the plants. So they can be also called as the water conducting tissue. As you can see here, the structure of the xylem, these are the hollow tubes which are made up of lignin. Can see all the structure. These are the lignins and they are the hollow tubes. They act as the main tissues which are, or you can say the channels which are responsible for the transportation of water and minerals. Next tissue is the phloem tissue, which is responsible for the transportation of sugar around the plant. That means from the leaves, these sugars has to be transported to the other parts of the plant. Like they are made up of living cells. Companion cells provide the energy for the tube cells. The end walls of the tube have pores through which food is transported from cell to cell in the form of dissolved sugars. As you can see in the picture, this is the tube like structure of the phloem. This is the end wall. This is the sieve tube. This is the companion cell, and this is structure of the phloem. Next comes the stomata cells. These are the tiny pores found on the surface of the leaf, and this is mainly responsible for the exchange of gas, or you can say for the evaporation of water. Now, stomata take up the CO2 from the air through stomata and it evaporates, or you can say the water vapor passes out from the leaf to the atmosphere through stomata. So the main two functions of stomata is to evaporate the water from the leaf, and it take in the carbon dioxide from the air through stomata. As you can see in the structure, this is the stomata, this is your guard cell, this is the chloroplast present, this is the thick inner wall. So this is the hole, this is the hole through which the exchange of exchange, or you can say the water is lost and the carbon dioxide is taken. So students, in this session we have seen about the materials, or you can say the need of transport system in the plants. In further session we will have a more detailed look on how the food and water is transmitted in the plants. Thank you.